Here's how they're depopulating the planet. What we've learned is this. If a country can maintain a constant population, it can feed its people most of the time. That's number one. If it doesn't have to, if it can't maintain a proper population balance, it has to resort to war and resource acquisition by attacking other countries. This has been going on since the beginning of time to feed its people. If every country on the planet stabilized their population and could feed their own people, peace could be maintained. We'd probably have no war. The problem is right now, Doug, we have 100 million people being born and added to the planet every single year. And the globalists and the United Nations have looked and said, hey, we can't allow this. We've got to cull the population. That's why they're going after our immune system. Remember now, if we have this condition right now with all of this nagalase in our bloodstream now from all these immunizations that we've been getting, if they introduce an H1N1 bird vaccine or Ebola or whatever, our immune systems wouldn't work efficiently against that. Yep. They'd have a much higher kill rate. So let's go back to this. We look back to ancient Rome and we wonder what the gladiators and we wondered how the Roman society could have been so cruel or how Hitler or Stalin killed tens of millions of their own people. But modern society is just as cruel, if not more cruel. The New World Order of today has marked mankind for slaughter. Their stated goals are to bring the population of the planet down to 500 million. Using the excuse of managing the global population, massive death programs are underway. We are all victims of this covert depopulation policy that seeks to reduce the population to a sustainable level of, again, 500 million. The primary methods that are being used are chemical and biological agents. We just discussed that, to undermine human fertility, sexuality, and immune systems, as well as a variety of psychosocial and economic methods to subvert the family unit. The method used to control population growth has been dictated by growth rate and the life in the existing infrastructures in the developing countries. In other words, if you're going to fluoridate the water, you can't do it in a country that doesn't have water treatment systems. You can't. You can't put fluoride in water that you're pumping out of a well with 1,000 little wells everywhere else. These methods have either been imposed by force or have been adopted willingly by the nation states and their leadership. This is what's happened to us in the United States. They have willingly done this to us. They know what they're doing, and they started it way back in the 40s when they introduced fluoride into the water supply. China has been using the one-child policy. India has used covert sterilization techniques. The U.S. and NATO countries have relied primarily on chemical sterilization and have done this either covertly, and they've also impaired the immune system. Fluoridation is being used to make the masses sterile and infertile. This was first used in the Nazi concentration camps. The concentration camps had to find a drug, a chemical, that would make the inmates servile and infertile. And they knew they couldn't get the inmates to take pills because they would spit them out. So they poisoned the water with fluoride. First attempt method of choice, it started in 1946. And it was either through tap water, through table salt, or milk, depending on the country being poisoned. Remember, Harvard says that when you ingest fluoride on a continual basis, then you have up to a 20-point drop in IQ scores. This is particularly true in children who are being given formula which contains fluoride because the water they're mixing it with contains fluoride. It's gotten so bad now that even the government has come in and reduced the fluoride standards by 50%. A few wealthy nations of Northern Europe who don't fluoridate their water, Doug, they use free dental plans to make sure that everyone gets a good dose of topical fluoride on a regular basis. This poison has been given to you under the lie that it prevents tooth decay. It does not. This is a complete and total lie. It is rat poison, period. That's all it is. Water fluoridation is over to 1 billion people now in the modern world, and it can only be used in modern infrastructures with special treatment water plants. Now, the next thing they do in Latin America and then throughout the Caribbean is they can't go in there with water treatment systems like that and do this, so they use salt fluoridation. Most people don't know this. They actually add fluoride to salt. And what that allows it to do is it allows it to be bound to the salt. They shake the fluoride directly on their food. And again, it's to be used to create a servile and infertile population. Now, this is very insidious because, again, everybody needs salt and everybody needs water, and they know that. A few years ago, I remember I was traveling out in Utah, Doug, and I remember I was over the Great Salt Lake, and I was shocked at all of the drying ponds and how many of the drying ponds and the amount of chemtrails that were being sprayed, dumping aluminum into the salt. Now, remember this. If the aluminum is being added to the salt because the salt basically is being completely contaminated by the chemtrails, which contain aluminum, and then they're mixing fluoride in with the salt, and then they're dumping glyphosate on all of our food. This is like a toxic trifecta. 1 billion pounds of glyphosate or Roundup is being used annually. 1 billion pounds. Now, fluoride is also used as insecticides. Now, everybody listen to me. There's an insecticide called cryolite. They use it on veggies and grapes. It's also in wine. It is a super poisonous product that uses fluoride to kill insects, and they spray it on your vegetables. That's why you've got to eat clean. You've got to eat organic. Then they use another one. It's called sulfural fluoride. They put it on beans and grains, and it's been linked to drops in IQ also. Let's not forget the toothpaste and the dental doctors who basically continue to give you fluoride treatments, and also dental mouthwashes that contain fluoride, and the dentists who refuse to read the latest Harvard research. Also, a lot of the white strips that are available that people use to whiten their teeth, they contain fluoride. So we have this continual bombardment of fluoride in our diets, which has been linked to IQ scores, sterility, and infertility. Almost every major city now, Doug, contains scores and scores of fertility clinics. And the reason for that is the baby boomers are having a difficult time. Well, we're past prime age now, but our children are having a difficult time in getting pregnant because they've been given so many of these drugs and so many of these chemicals in their diet. And this is all being done on purpose. Now, to close the loop on the folks who say no to water fluoride, by drinking bottled water, starting around 1980, BPA has been used in all plastic bottles in almost all plastic. Some of it's coming out now. This is bisphenol A, and they replace glass bottles. And this is another fertility depressing chemical. BPA, bisphenol A, is a xenoestrogen. Men's sperm counts are now down by as much as 90%. There's two types of these plastics. There's polycarbonates, which you use or BPA plastics like water bottles, and there's epoxy resins that are used on the inside of cans. Now, I'm going to shake you up in a second because almost all organic canned goods still have epoxy resins made with bisphenol A. So if you're buying organic vegetables in a can, you're still getting a huge dose of BPA from the can. BPA is ingested when it leaches into the bottled water and food that we carry. Almost every can in the world is lined with epoxy resins loaded with BPA. Chronic exposure plus most organics, frozen veggies, are in BPA bags. In other words, you get frozen vegetables, they are in plastic bags that contain BPA. Most organic cans contain BPA. So folks who are using and buying more expensive organic canned goods and plastics are spending extra money and being poisoned by this xenoestrogen compound. Now, there are some organic manufacturers who don't use BPA in their cans or plastic bags. I'm going to give you those right now that we know of. There's probably more. These are the ones that we personally use when we buy organic food. We buy it from Amy's, from Farmer's Market, from Eden, from Field Day, and from Wolfgang Puck. They don't use BPA liners in their cans, and they don't use plastic bags for their vegetables or for their foods. Okay, now remember, BPA is being specifically targeted. It was put back into the food supply through the cans back in the 40s and 50s as liners, because they used to not have liners in the cans. And what BPA does, when you give it to a woman and she's eating canned foods, etc., or drinking out of plastic bottles, it massively increases her estrogen content if she's pregnant. And when that happens, if she's pregnant with a little boy, the sexual differentiation occurs after the first trimester, and the little boy's that ovaries become testicles, et cetera, because of testosterone being produced from her ovaries and adrenal glands. If you give the woman exogenous estrogens when she's pregnant, what ends up happening is the ovaries simply cannot produce enough testosterone, the adrenal glands cannot produce enough testosterone, and that little boy becomes feminized. He goes from a left-brain male to a right-brain-dominated female brain. And so he becomes very, very feminized. He has tremendous gender confusion. And this is happening all of the time in the United States right now. Now, let me read you some more of this. This feminization using canned food is aimed primarily at the urban and rural poor, who are more likely to eat canned soups, getting more of their share of fertility-reducing agents. Since the depopulation lobby wants eugenics or better genes, they feel a greater reduction of the poor is a desired outcome. Remember, this goes right back to Darwin with his Origin of the Species, all the way to Margaret Sanger, all the way to Hitler, all the way to the New World Order, all the way to the UN. Next, the spraying of aluminum oxide for GMO engineering, which we've already mentioned, are another form of population control. We are literally being sprayed like bugs. I also believe that Morgellons disease is something else that is coming from these chemtrails that they are spraying on us. And what Morgellons disease is, you can look it up online, is you have these fibers that start working their way out of your body that cause all these infection sites and sores all over your body. And they've tried to analyze these fibers, and they're saying they're almost like from an alien origin. They don't know what they are. But they do know one thing. When these fibers are exposed to a certain sound frequency, they start growing and replicating. So that's kind of scary because the entire planet now is surrounded by satellites, which can emit certain frequency levels, which could probably make these Morgellons stuff start growing if they wanted it to. So I don't know if they're going to be using that for the protocol for the United for helping to kill people or not. I don't know. That's, again, speculation on mine. But remember, back in the 90s, I remember, Doug, we had a problem with what's called the Mediterranean fruit fly here in the United States. And the Mediterranean fruit fly was attacking the orange groves, and they started spraying us with DC-3s filled with malathion. This is a nerve agent, okay? It's an unbelievably poisonous insecticide, and they started spraying us with these planes all over Polk County, all over Central Florida, until it was finally stopped by a court order out of Tallahassee. So they don't care if they spray us like bugs. They don't care. It doesn't make any difference to them. That's what they will do. The spraying of aluminum has unintended consequences. These are probably intended consequences. It poisons the air, it poisons the water, and it poisons the land. Makes the growing of heirloom seeds literally impossible. That's why Monsanto now has the entire line of seeds that are aluminum-resistant seeds. This is forcing many farmers globally out of business, which allows the agri-giants, again, to buy their land, controlled by the big banking communities, again, the Sabbatane, Frankist, Kabbalist, Luciferian, Rothschilds. Okay, then they are breaking the back of organic farming all around the world because they're polluting the land so much. Now, primarily, these chemtrails, this geoengineering, is only being used in NATO countries because they have to have air rights to fly over. This is causing many, many corporations to buy aluminum-resistant GMO seeds, which is basically another form of insecticide. These insecticide genes that are put into this corn and this cotton and these soybeans, it really, really makes the plant kind of a poison. And what happens is when these bees are coming to pollinate it, they're poisoned by the plants because they're basically insecticides. Remember, aluminum particulates combined with the fluoride, that greatly increases fluoride toxicity, and it greatly reduces the human body's toxicity threshold level. In other words, aluminum, when you combine it with fluoride, is much more toxic than just fluoride by itself. So together, they are a deadly combination. Let's say, for instance, you want to go down to the municipality, and they're using recycled water, and they've got to clear it up, or they're pulling it out of a river or a stream, and it's got a lot of debris and stuff floating in it. When the municipality does this, they add what's called they add aluminum sulfate to it. It's also called alum. And what happens is this clears up the water. It's a clarification agent. So what they do is they clear up the water with aluminum first. Then they add the fluoride to the aluminum by adding the fluoride to the water later. So you're getting a deadly dose of fluoride and aluminum in the water. A test was done using aluminum fluoride in the 90s to see what would happen to mice who were given both aluminum and fluoride. The problem was that 80% of the rats that were tested in the study died before the end of the study from aluminum fluoride toxicity. There's a synergistic effect that takes place when these elements are combined. This finding was made part of the Federal Registry in December the 4th, 2004. Now, I'm going to read you a news release that was released in 1998 that nobody knows about. Nobody realizes it even happened. This is a news release, April 22nd, 1998. You can look it up online, from the Medical Journal Brain Research, Volume 784, 1998. And here's what it said. It revealed that aluminum-induced neural degeneration in rats, this is Alzheimer's basically in rats, is greatly enhanced when the animals were given low doses of fluoride in combination with the aluminum. The presence of fluoride enhanced the bioavailability of the aluminum, causing more aluminum to cross the blood-brain barrier and become deposited in the brain. The aluminum levels in the brains were twice that of the control group. And guess what? Again, aluminum sulfate, alum, is added to almost all of our drinking water to clarify the water, and then the water is fluorinated. Can you believe this stuff, Doug? I mean, I hate just to do a monologue on the show like this. That's what they're doing to us. They're literally poisoning us, putting aluminum in the water first, and then they dump a big load of fluoride in the water. And when they do this, It allows them to massively increase the amount of aluminum that's being put into the brain. What we need to realize is this, is that we've got to stop getting aluminum contamination on our bodies. Now, if you combine all of this stuff together, this stuff they're putting in the immunizations, these viral implications, all of this stuff with all the aluminum, they're intentionally, Doug, trying to depopulate the planet. And the problem is they're not killing us fast enough because of the growth rate, so they're doing more and more and more to do it, more and more different ways of killing us. So what they do is they come in now with immunizations that are tainted. Now, we know already they did this through the World Health Organization with the smallpox vaccines that were tainted along with the blood transfusions back in the 70s with the AIDS virus. And we know that there's a specific targeting gene inside of the AIDS virus that directly attacks black Americans. We know that. It's like it was directly intended to kill black people. The problem is, Doug, that what happened with these black folks, and they didn't understand this, is that they were reproducing at such high levels in Africa that they continued to reproduce even if they had AIDS, and they were having 4 and 5 children before they died of AIDS in their middle 20s. And all these children have been left now running all over Africa. I saw them all over Nairobi who have no parents. And so it wasn't effective enough. So now they went back in, according to Dr. Francis Boyle, and he was interviewed on Alex Jones last year about the Ebola thing, and he said the boys out of Fort Detrick apparently have gotten involved, and they're trying to tweak the Ebola vaccine. And what they were saying over there in Sierra Leone is that the people that were getting the Ebola vaccine were the ones that were coming down with Ebola, in which thousands and thousands and thousands of people died. And so finally, these guys in these villages got so mad at the Red Cross, they were going in and stoning them and killing these aid workers because everybody who was getting these immunizations seemed to be dying of Ebola. So even the folks in Africa, in these third world countries that are totally uneducated, started to realize that these people were being killed by the immunizations that were being tested on them back a year and a half ago. See, we need to understand something here. They don't care. These Sabbatain, Frankens, Kabbalists, bankers that run the planet, they don't look at you or me as a human being, Doug. They don't do that. They see us as animals. They see us as soulless creatures. They don't care if they kill us or stamp us out or eradicate us. They don't care because it's all about profit to these guys and obeying their master, Lucifer. That's all they care about.
Exactly. Yeah, you're exactly correct.
I started to realize the extent of the depravity of this whole situation. And I'm using this word very, very clearly, the extent of the depravity. I mean, these people are literally hell-bent on killing us. They really, really don't care. They want to depopulate this planet no matter what it takes.